just been put on in the spring.
He's gonna suck it.
I thought it was a citrus tree of some kind, so I didn't know. I just wanted you to identify it.
All right. Well, hey, everybody, and welcome back to the garden. I'm Melissa Allman, and this is Steve Pennell, and you just heard him say he knew this was a citrus tree, but he wanted me to come out and hopefully identify it. So what we found out is this is actually a trifoliate orange, and the botanical name is Poncyrus trifoliata. And you can see how big it gets. These things can grow in a heat zone up to about a 5, and they get to be shrubby or tree form. And you can see this one's pretty much tree form. I know Oklahoma State University has a whole hedge of these, and they used to use them as hedges way back in the day, and you see why. Nobody would want to cross this. Now, the ways you can identify this thing, Steve, is by those thorns that can be anywhere from 3 to 5 inches long. And the leaf, as you can see, has 3 leaflets on it. They do have a little orange that grows on them, and they're going to be green in the beginning, and they're going to go ahead and ripen up to a yellow. So that's why you thought it might have been a lemon, but it's actually a very bitter orange that's not edible. Mm-hmm. But some people do like to take them and use them as a marmalade. So, or they can dry them and they powder them, and they can use them kind of as a spice in some different dishes.
Okay, I was just wondering if it could be crossed with a sweet orange.
Actually, they can be crossed with a sweet orange. They'll take the flowers of this one, which is the Poncyrus trifoliata, and they'll cross it with a Citrus sinensis, which is a sweet orange, and they will actually get a sweeter orange, but they're still so bitter they just about can't eat them. The interesting thing about these trees is they can take the rootstock, and then they can take the plant of another citrus and graft them onto each other so that they can have a healthier plant for a colder environment. But Steve, tell us where we're located right now.
We're about 50 foot from the Appalachee River.
And it's absolutely beautiful back in here. So that tells me that the soil that they require is gonna need to be a little more moist and probably a little sandy. I think they can handle a little bit of clay as long as there is some sand in it. But they love woodland settings like this one, and some sunny edges of woodland areas too. And this place is beautiful. This is like something out of a picture.
Yeah, and it's definitely sandy down in here. You can see spots with sand, you know, in places.
Now, does this place flood a lot?
Oh yeah, when the rain is normal and everything, usually this would be probably, maybe a little further out, be watered. You probably couldn't get over here on the four-wheelers, you know.
Wow.
Yeah, I've seen it like that this spring.
So it was wet all out
right,
in here?
You couldn't come all the way across it because the water was running all through it. The river was so high. We was getting a lot of rain, you know, back in the spring.
Oh my gosh. So actually we got lucky being able to find them.
Yeah.
Now these things probably will not be ripe until later on in the fall. They still have a little bit of growing to do. Okay, right here are the little baby oranges, and you can see, well, I wish you could feel them. They're so fuzzy. Now this is what they look like in November. But the flowers on this is going to be white with some pink stamens. And just so you know, if you would like to propagate them or grow any yourself, you can start it from seed, which they are polyembryonic. And all that means is that when the seed comes up, it's usually going to have 2 or more babies to it. And you can tell on the trunk of this one. Also, if you would like to take cuttings of it, you can take cuttings of this newer green wood, which a lot of it looks green, but I would stick with about an 8-inch to 1-foot long cutting and just stick it in some sandy soil. That you can do in July or August. If you want to layer them, you can do that around October. And I can't wait to see some of the fruits once they ripen up, and just to see what they look like.
What's on it in the fall.
Because they are fuzzy. mm-hmm. too. They don't look like a real orange. They stay pretty fuzzy.
Yep. Well, I was just wondering where these might have come from, because it's kind of weird for them to be in the what we call the swamp here.
Well, it could have came from a lot of places, Steve. It could have just been grown here. These things are able to grow all the way up to zone 5 in the United States. Another way that they possibly could have gotten here by seed is either from the Appalachee River, because I know y'all seen birds. And any certain variety of birds? Are they the kind that migrate?
Usually the big birds, you know.
The big ones? Are they the kind that migrate?
Usually the big birds, you know.
The big ones? Are they the kind that migrate?
Usually the big birds, you know.
The big ones? So he just told us that's how they got here. They could have flown up and deposited the seeds that way, or they could have came in with a river. So that's a good question.
Right.
It's a real good question. That was cool. So if y'all find one of these, there is no way you can miss what this is. Especially with these thorns.
Right.
I bet that'd flatten a tire, wouldn't it?
Yep. For sure.
Or leave a mark.
I bet you <that'd be in it. laughs> Oh my God.
All right, well, Steve, I appreciate you bringing us out here and letting us look at this tree. This is awesome. So we really do appreciate it. I grew
You're
up
welcome.
With Steve.
You're welcome.
So, okay, and we will see you next time here back at the garden.